Good morning, students. After a long silence, let us have a discussion regarding your lesson. We have already discussed about a number of theories given by a number of psychologists like Piaget, Erikson, Asubel, Bandura. So today let me discuss about a theory of social constructivism and which is also known as socio-cultural theory. So students, we must take crisis as an opportunity. Now we are living with some crisis, so let us take this crisis as our opportunity to continue our learning through online mode. So I am going to tell about a psychologist who was a Russian psychologist, born in Russia, died in Russia. And he was died at an early age, and he developed a very important theory of cognitive development. He was Vygotsky, a very famous psychologist. At an early age, he was considered as known as Mozart of psychology because he was a very classical psychologist and published more than 200 scientific articles and died at a very early age. He was developed social theory of social constructivism. He was an exponent of social constructivism. You know that I'll discuss with you that so far the social constructivism and is concerned, it is related to constructivist school of thoughts. Basically, there are three types of constructivism. One is cognitive constructivism, that is developed by Piaget, and social constructivism, that is developed by Vygotsky, and radical constructivism, that is developed by von Grassoff-Fried. So today we shall have a discussion regarding social constructivism or social constructivism theory of Vygotsky, which is also in another way known as socio-cultural theory, which was developed by the famous psychologist Vygotsky. So let us have a discussion regarding the theoretical concepts, the main theoretical concepts. What are the main theoretical concepts and what he had said about this theory? The main theoretical concepts The main theoretical concept of Vygotsky, very interesting students, he explained this theory in relation to culture and social process. So the main theoretical concept first is role of social process and culture for cognitive development. Generally, students, we know that cognitive process, it is our intellectual abilities, which consist of a number of intellectual characteristics, a number of cognitive characteristics, how we know and how we understand the world. But Vygotsky was an interesting person, and he said that intellectual abilities or cognitive abilities developed through social and cultural process. Knowledge can be constructed through social activity. In this context, he says knowledge can be constructed through social activity. Through social activity. And he explained the construction of knowledge in the context of social process, and culture. So, construction of knowledge through social process and culture. So, how knowledge can be constructed through social process and culture? Man is a rational social animal, what Aristotle has said. Why man is a social animal? Because we live in society and we are making interaction with different peoples around us. Who are they? They are our parents, starting from our birth. We born and brought up by our family members. They are our parents, our siblings. And in a larger sphere, we make interaction with teachers and the neighbors, other persons of the society. So we learn many ideas, many concepts, many values, many skills from these people. So that is a social process. Because when we make, for example, when we make interaction with our parents, father and mother, they teach us so many things in life. We develop ideas, development of concepts, ideas, skills, attitude through social interaction. That is the social process, because they are more experienced people than us, than the child. When child is less experienced and they are more experienced. And when the child interacts with more experienced person in the society, he learns many things. His thinking will develop. So, the higher mental functions can be developed through this social interaction. That is what the social context of our intellectual abilities. And in this context, again I am telling one thing, that Vygotsky has said, we have not just copied the behavior of our parents or the peoples around us. We have not just copied. There is an internalization process. We imitate, we learn, and then we internalize the behavior, or we internalize the ideas what we receive from our society. So through this process of internalization, so that is through the process of internalization, process of internalization, we develop many concepts, many scales, and we developed our thinking, what to think and how to think, how to solve a problem and how to deal with others and how to complete the task. So many things we have developed. So Vygotsky has said they are our cognitive tools. What he has said? He has said that they are our cognitive tools. The members, through the social process, they are our cognitive tools, because these people, they provide or they contribute for our cognitive development. So they are considered as the cognitive tool. So that is the social process, how we interact and develop our intellectual ability. They are our parents, they are our teachers, they are our parents, they may be our parents, they may be our teachers, they may be our peers, siblings, or neighbors. So any significant people in our life, any experienced person which we come across, we learn from them and we construct our knowledge. That is how knowledge is being constructed through social process. Similarly, culture, it is comparatively a wider concept than the social process. So we live and nurture in a culture, and culture is very specific to our life, very specific to our social process. And culture is different from people to people. A specific group of individual, they have a specific culture, and it has its influence on the life of the child. Because suppose, for example, nurturing a child in a family, it is also different from community to community, society to society. It is according to their culture. So as culture different from people to people, so Vygotsky has said, so far the culture context is concerned, as it is different from society to society, or culture is different, so cognitive ability is also different. That is why social process is also different, culture is also different. That is why there is difference in cognitive ability. And on the basis of this social process, social interaction, when we experience, we develop our experience, we construct knowledge through our experience, and we construct knowledge through the help of these people. We construct knowledge through the help of these people, because there is a process that is called mediation process. In between, there is a process that is called mediation, which in layman term, we can say mediator. So that mediation process takes place between society and the child, between society and the individual. So through this mediation process, through which we can mediate, we can interact with the people of the society. So that is how we construct knowledge. So that is the first basic theme of the Vygotsky theory. And in this context, one more important thing I will tell you, that is learning takes place, or knowledge can be constructed at two levels. Learning takes place
or knowledge can be constructed at two levels. One on a social plane, that means learning through social process. How takes place learning through social process? That is interaction between people. And that is Vygotsky has said, that is inter-psychological. That means when there is interaction between people or the child with the society or members of the society, that is learning on social plane. That is inter-psychological. Between people. And another is learning takes place on individual level. That is individual level. One is social level, then another is individual level. That is intra-psychological. So you might have idea regarding inter and intra. Intra is between people, and when the child interacts with himself and develops his potentiality, that is intra-psychological. So learning or knowledge can be constructed. In this context, let me clarify about how knowledge is being constructed. So we must always remember that knowledge has its existence in this world, in this environment. We can get knowledge from people, they are the source of knowledge. We can get knowledge from nature, that is also the source of knowledge. So we can get knowledge from technology, we can get knowledge from books. So there are different sources of knowledge, multi sources of knowledge. Child has to make interaction with all these sources to construct his knowledge. Book may be a source of knowledge. So when child gets some knowledge through social process, or when the child will interact with people and construct his knowledge, that is a type of learning on social plane, on social level. And when the child, after getting that knowledge from different sources, from parents, from teachers, from siblings, from peers, then the child will develop his cognitive capacity through the internalization process, develops his thinking. So that is learning takes place inside the individual or through intra process, that is intra-psychological. So the first theme, first main theme which was given by Vygotsky was role of social process for cognitive development. So Vygotsky has said that cognitive development is an active process, and that active process is related to social process and culture. So that is why that theory is also known as socio-cultural theory, through which the child develops his intellectuality. That means what the child received from through the social process, through the culture, that has become transmitted into intellectual process. Through the process of internalization. So it is a process of internalization and also transmission. So this is one part of the theory. Thank you. So let me discuss about the next part of the theory.
बंद करो।